This video is based on a movie titled Den of Thieves. Alert spoilers ahead. This movie begins with an armored vehicle moving through the streets of Los Angeles. The vehicle comes to a stop where two of the four officers inside go in to get some foodstuffs. A car arrives and armed men wearing gas masks come out. The officers come out and are ordered to stop and not move while a second car arrives. The driver of the armored vehicle alerts the police just before he is ordered to get out, to which he refuses. They cut through the windscreen and pull it out with the SUV. One of the officers who had gone in the store tries to take his gun and is shot and his partner hit on the head. The driver is also shot as he is reaching for his gun and then dragged out of the vehicle. A man, Mac, alerts the armed men of the police approaching the scene, after which they break the back door using an explosive. One of the men explodes a sanitizer in the SUV as another pulls out the officer in the back of the vehicle. Police arrive and a shootout commences where one of the armed men, Marcus, is shot and killed alongside most officers. The shootout ends, after which they leave in the armored vehicle and the car, leaving behind the SUV. The drive off as Merriman complains about the events while Mac gives them directions. They arrive at a warehouse where several men are waiting and alight the vehicles once inside. As they undress and dispose of the clothes, Merriman keeps on complaining to Bosco as Donnie and Ensign watch. Merriman orders Bosco to go back to the scene and check, which authorities respond. A detective, Big Nick, drives on an estate road and comes to a stop outside his house. He tries to go in through the back door, but finds it locked, after which he uses a window to go in. He goes to the kitchen and takes milk from the fridge while his wife comes down the stairs. He is startled to see her, after which they talk for a while, then the wife leaves. She later comes down with the children carrying bags, after which she takes them to her car. She argues with Nick for a while, then leaves, telling him to stay away from them. He goes into the house, and as he is seated thinking of this, he gets a call about the robbery. He arrives at the scene and finds his colleagues surrounding Marcus, where they mock him about how bad he looks. He eats a donut from the crime scene, after which he is briefed of the situation while Bosco takes pictures. FBI shows up and Nick talks to the in-charge, Bob, where they mock each other and joke around. Merriman and his team go over the pictures taken by Bosco and research about Nick. Nick and his team work on finding out who is responsible when they come up with a theory on Donnie. Donnie is at the club where he works as a bartender with his friends who make jokes about his work. Nick shows up and starts talking to Donnie, after which he pays him in excess, then leaves after some time. Donnie goes out to his car after a shift, and just as he is about to leave, he is shocked with a taser and knocked out. He wakes up later and finds himself on a bed in a room where a door opens, and Nick walks across the room. He wakes up and follows him out the door to the room. He finds Nick with his team from the major crimes department alongside some ladies. They mock him for a while, after which the ladies are asked to leave the room. They then sit and interrogate him while Nick pushes him to give answers to questions asked by choking him. He then gives into the pushing and gives them a fabricated version of the story of his relation with Merriman's team. He tells them of how he met each one of them, including when Merriman gets out of prison just before they meet. Donnie goes on a test ride with Merriman to show his skill, which impresses him a lot. He tells them about his first mission with the team and the money they got. They later release him, after which he boards a bus home, on which he receives a call with instructions to go somewhere. Nick goes shopping and comes across his wife and children, with whom they look at each other then leave. Merriman and Bosco come up and pick Donnie while Nick and his team dig into the case. He drives the whole team to the Los Angeles branch of the Federal Reserve, where he explains more about it. Meanwhile, Nick and his team dig deep enough to find out the link between Merriman and each member of his team. Merriman tells them of the plan to rob the Federal Reserve and explains how exactly it functions. Donnie makes a deal with a woman from a fast food shop for food delivery services. Nick and his team are at the parking lot when he is handed divorce papers by an attorney. He informs the others about the situation, then gets into his car and starts reading the papers. Merriman gives the crew more information on the plan, where Ensign asks where he got the information from. Donnie goes into the Federal Reserve to deliver some food while both Nick's and Merriman's team are watching. He manages to go through the security and delivers the food to two women in the cafeteria. He later goes into the bathroom with some of the packed food and places it on the ceiling in one of the toilets. He then leaves the building as both teams watch on. Nick and his team keep talking about the possibility of Merriman and his team breaking into the Federal Reserve. Ensign's daughter has prepared herself when a young man comes in to pick her up for a date. He compliments her and her mom, after which Ensign comes up. He calls him into a room with Merriman and a group of huge men, where they go in and lock the door. Ensign tells him that he has to be responsible for his daughter for that night, after which a man shouts at him. He then leaves, followed by Ensign, after which all the men burst into laughter about it. Nick and his team go into a restaurant where they find Merriman and his team having dinner. Nick comes up to Merriman's table and greets Donnie, saying how he knows him from the gym. He then talks to Merriman about knowing him from a while ago, to which he denies. He insists on this and goes ahead to abuse people on the table, to which Merriman stands up. One of Nick's colleagues, Gus Henderson, comes in and settles the contention, after which they leave. Merriman and his team gang up against Donnie and accuse him of being a cop or working with the police. They interrogate him at gunpoint, of which he tells them of how he knows Nick and orders him to tell him to be ready on Friday. Nick goes to Rolling Hills Estate in a house where he finds his wife and a friend alongside the owner and his wife. Nick asks for a pen and signs the papers he was given earlier, while he warns the friend of touching his kids. He insults him while the owner of the house kicks him out, to which they almost fight, and then leaves. Donnie comes in at a clothes store and informs Nick and his team that something is happening on Friday. He tells them he does not know where, but they should wear bulletproof vests. Nick goes into a shooting range where he finds Merriman and his team sharpening their shooting skills. After some kind of competition, Merriman and his team leave Nick and go on their way. Nick goes into a strip club, and after watching them strip, he asks to talk to one who is in relation with Merriman. Merriman goes into a house and finds the woman there, after which Nick shows up. They stare for a while, after which Merriman goes into a room with the woman as Nick leaves. Nick gets into his car and informs his team where Merriman and his team are going to attack. The woman tells Merriman that she did what he asked. Merriman leaves in the morning with some bags, which he puts in his car. Ensign's daughter leaves for school after breakfast, where her dad hugs her and waves goodbye. Nick stops his car next to the fence of the school where his daughter, McKenna, goes. He calls unto her, after which they talk and joke for a while, then the bell rings. She leaves for class, and he gets in his car, where he weeps for a while, then drives off. Merriman and Ensign are preparing their weapons when Bosco and Donnie arrive. Nick arrives at the station and finds his team preparing themselves and their weapons, to which he joins. He leads his team out, where they go and waits for Merriman and his team to show up, to which they do. Merriman and his team go out of the van carrying guns and go into Pico Rivera Savings and Loan as Nick and his team watch. They shoot the cameras and order the guard to lie on the floor and everyone else to come to the center of the room. One of them goes through other rooms in the building searching for other people and sends the manager out. They tie up the guard and order everyone to kneel, after which they take their cell phones and tie them up. Merriman takes the manager and orders him to call the police, informing them of the robbery and giving them instructions. He vows to kill a hostage each time the police break the instructions given. Nick and his team are seated in their cars when a report comes in of the robbery going on at Pico Rivera. They make a call back to prevent the police from responding, but are too late since sirens are heard as they arrive. Nick and his team try to prevent them from coming in, but more police show up, and the situation gets out of hand. Nick and Bob argue for a moment while the manager opens the door to the cash vault. The negotiator calls in to speak with Merriman, of which they break one of the rules. This leads to one of the hostages being taken away, after which a gunshot is heard. Nick and Bob's argument escalates to a point in which they almost fight. The negotiator calls in again and talks to the manager about the demands being met, after which he is told not to call again. Merriman calls Nick on his cell and talks to him while he watches him through the curtains. As Nick and the police make plans on how they will go in, Ensign creates a huge explosion that shocks everyone. Mac eavesdrops on a call from Alameda to the Federal Reserve on a drop to Pico Rivera. Nick asks Bob what the plans are, then decides to go in by himself, which angers Bob. His team follows him into the bank while the rest of the police watch in awe. Nick finds a hole in the vault and goes in pursuit of Merriman, just as the woman who was to be shot cries in a bathroom. Merriman and his team go out a sewer hole, while the rest of Nick's team come into the bank. They later spot the hole, and as they look inside, one man asks Nick where he is while he goes through underground tunnels. Mac makes a call to the Federal Reserve, while pretending to be from Alameda, and asks about the drop to the Federal Reserve. Nick goes through the tunnel and finds the staircase leading to the ground above through a sewer hole. Merriman and Ensign go into the Federal Reserve pretending to be bringing the drop from Alameda. They confirm Donnie's position just as Bosco takes out some construction signs from his car. They offload the money from the vehicle and bring it in as Bosco goes down a sewer hole. Merriman and Ensign hand over the money in the trolleys and are left waiting. Nick and his team go out of the bank and hand over the crime scene to Bob, then leave. They put on earpieces and communicate with Donnie, who gives clearance on Bosco, who turns out the lights. All the workers go out of the money count rooms, after which Donnie turns on an EMP while in one of the trolleys. He comes out of the trolley while the guards notice the camera in that room is not working well. Mac intercepts a call to the restaurant where a lady asks why her delivery took too long, which he informs Merriman. The guards try to override the system to make the camera better, but it does not happen, to which one goes to check it out. He calls to Luigi, who is in the room where the camera has issues, but Ensign creates a disturbance on the signal. His colleague tells him to go and find Luigi in the cafeteria and talk to him about it. Donnie takes the chance to pack the targeted cash in bags. The guard finds Luigi and comes with him and his partner just as Donnie throws the cash out onto a trash can. He then goes into the air vents just as Luigi and his partner go in and checks around the room. Bosco brings back the lights just as Nick gives directions to his team on what to do about finding Merriman and his team. Luigi and his partner go on to count the money by Alameda and get the exact amount and give back the trolleys with cash. Merriman and Ensign are released with their trolleys while a man takes the trash to the truck and heads out. Donnie manages to go through the vents and comes down in the bathroom. He takes the food he had hidden earlier in the ceiling and delivers it to the women he had delivered to earlier. The man with the garbage truck meets another with a garbage truck, with whom they signal each other, then go in opposite directions. Donnie heads towards the gate while cars with Nick's team are seen rushing off. The security guard notices that Donnie's name is not on the sign and list, and then releases him after some explanation. Merriman and Ensign are then given a go-ahead to leave while the woman who received the food calls security to stop Donnie. Bosco follows the garbage truck and gives directions to Merriman on their location. Merriman intercepts the truck and Bosco forces the driver out, after which they drive off, leaving the driver there. Nick and his team catch up with Donnie as he heads to Mac and put him in their car, where they beat him up. He gives into the beating and tells them the location where they were supposed to meet up. Mac calls Merriman and informs him of Donnie being caught, to which he hangs up. Merriman and his team burn up their clothes as he tells of the others being caught. Nick spots them just as they leave the garbage site and drives on in pursuit while alerting the rest of his team. They get into a traffic jam where Merriman and his team are up ahead and Nick and his team following behind. Merriman, Ensign and Bosco wear body armor, and as they prepare their weapons, Nick and his team alight from their car. The rest of Nick's team arrive as Merriman and his team alight from their car. A shootout starts up where Bosco is shot and killed while some of Nick's colleagues are seriously injured. Donnie is cuffed up in the car watching this as Merriman and Ensign run off. Ensign is shot on the neck and falls to the ground, where he bleeds out. Nick runs after Merriman and catches up with him, where they shoot at each other. Nick gets a hand injury while Merriman dies from gunshots from Nick. Nick goes back to the car and realizes that Donnie uncuffed himself and ran away. They later realize that there was no money in Merriman's car, after which Bob comes up and talks to Nick for a while. Nick is seated in his office when he spots Donnie's picture on the analysis wall and goes out looking for him. He spots an old picture of a football team where Donnie is the goalkeeper, which makes him realize they were played. Donnie serves liquor to a customer as a flashback is shown on how he was the mastermind of the whole operation. The movie ends as he asks the customer where he works and offers to pay for his beer. Please subscribe to our channel for more of such videos, share our videos, and leave a comment on the comment section.